Hey everyone, and welcome to Freethink's Progress Report. I'm Nick, and I'm here with some stories about what's moving forward in the world today. And today we're actually going to be talking about a story that's very near and dear to... Hi.
Hey.
Hey Taylor, how are you today?
I'm fantastic, how are you?
I'm good. Can I ask how you got into my house?
Through your door. I've actually been thinking a lot about how to get into buildings recently.
That's an extremely creepy thing to say. Can you tell me more?
Yes, okay. So in a bunch of places, we flatten the curve, like here in San Francisco.
Okay.
However, we're not gonna have a vaccine for months, if not years.
Right.
And places are starting to open up right now. And we know that coronavirus spreads way easier indoors versus out of doors. So what are the security checks that we're gonna have as we enter buildings just to make sure that nobody has coronavirus inside that building?
How are other countries handling this?
So there's this viral video right now with this kid in China where he goes through 4 or 5 sanitation stations before he can enter his school.
Right.
You're also seeing things like in Taiwan where people are doing temperature checks as they enter the building.
What does it look like in the US?
The problem is that you can't test everyone for coronavirus every day. One of the things that hasn't gotten covered in the news a lot is how are hospital workers actually entering the building?
Right.
And the reason why I think this is actually really interesting is that, you know, the hospital is where we take sick people. It is literally a hot spot. And so if one doctor has coronavirus, he or she could spread it throughout the entire hospital. So how do you actually get all of your healthcare workers into a building every day? And we're talking about hundreds, if not thousands of people.
Right.
We actually have some friends over at UCSF, and they had to face this problem a few weeks ago when the pandemic was really starting to hit the United States. And I thought they had a really clever solution to this.
So UCSF is about 25,000 employees. March 13th, I got a phone call on a Saturday afternoon saying the city and county of San Francisco has a mandate to start screening all employees before they come into work. We were facing long lines of employees at the entrances to the hospital that needed to be screened to make sure that we were keeping patients and our workers safe.
So a long line is no fun, but is it really a health hazard?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, let's say there's someone that is infected with coronavirus and they've been waiting in line for 15 minutes. They've probably infected the people around them. I mean, I think about this every time I've had to go to the grocery store. I'm like, this is the time when I'm actually going to catch this thing, waiting in this line.
So how did they handle this if they can't check everybody as they go through the door?
Technology.
We worked with a partner called Conversa Health to design a digital tool that we released to our employees.
So the goal was to create a screener that would allow people easily to assess their exposure risk, at the time also their travel risk, and their symptoms. We went to work the next day, and within 5 days, we had a pilot version launched. So every day, a healthcare worker coming into the hospital takes a screen in the morning, and it screens them either you have to stay home, and if so, here are the follow-ups you need to go through with your occupational health department. And if you're cleared for work, you have to wear a mask. And then can you work with or not with immunocompromised patients? And it provides a badge back to their device that they have to show to get into a building.
And so it's kind of like TSA pre-check. So as you go through security in the building, you just show it, i.e. no more lines.
The waiting times went down from 25 minutes to just a minute or two at peak wait times. Now we're at about 4,000 or 5,000 employees a day who are using the tool.
Yes.
So,
I'm sorry, are you going?
Yeah, I was going to go.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
Okay, sorry.
What does this look like for most of us in our daily lives? How is this going to actually impact us?
Well, maybe if you're going into your office building or restaurant or even your comic book store, maybe you'll have to do a screener app like this and show security as you go through the door. Maybe this is what this looks like for the foreseeable future until we actually have a vaccine.
Goes without saying there's a lot of privacy concerns here, and it's also super inconvenient. Do you think that's really realistic?
I mean, the parallel example is, you know, metal detectors to go into festivals or into a club. It's annoying. It's some level of invasion of privacy, but we all do it to feel a sense of safety.
Are you sticking around for a drink or what?
No, I'm gonna go, but I did get June bugs from tuna. Judy, do you have a can opener actually? Forgot it.
No, I don't have a can opener.
Okay, I'll go get one.
Yeah, I guess the thought that counts. But what do you think? Would you be willing to enter your health data into a questionnaire just to enter a retail store or any other building? Let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you soon. And if someone has a can opener, that would be super, super helpful right now.